Hi, this is Eileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the orientation tools in Magix. Orientation is an important aspect of build preparation, as it can influence the Z-height of a build, the build time, the number of parts that fit into a scene, the build risks, and even the generated support and the post-processing needed. In Magix, you have four ways of orientating your parts. We'll start with the simplest one and proceed to the more complex ones. First, the rotation tool. Select your part, go to the Tools ribbon, and then click Rotate. You can enter the degrees of rotation and click on Apply. Alternatively, you can use the interactive rotation circles. The red, green, and blue 3D circles rotate your part around the X, Y, and Z axes respectively. The blue 2D circle will rotate your part in 2D. The next option is the bottom top plane tool. This function orientates your part to make an indicated surface a bottom plane or a top plane. For example, if it's very important to protect a surface from support, you can make it an upper plane. On the other hand, if the quality of a surface is not too important, for example, if that surface will not be visible in the final product, you can make it a bottom plane so that it will be supported. Select your part, go to the build preparation or position ribbon, and click on bottom top plane. Make your selection for bottom or upper plane. Click on Indicate Plane and click on the plane on your part. As soon as you click Apply, your part will be reorientated. If you need something more advanced, you can use the Orientation Comparator. This tool will calculate different orientations based on the priorities you define and give you a comparison of these orientations. You just need to go to the Build Preparation or Position ribbon and click on Orientation Comparator. On the pop-up window, you can add or delete priorities. In this case, three orientations will be calculated. One with the shortest Z height, one with the smallest support surface, and one with the smallest maximum XY section. Here, we have our three orientations with support previews. On this window, you can remove any data that you're not interested in seeing. In order to compare the orientations, all you need to do is click on the icon next to your orientation of choice. Now I can see that, compared to the orientation I chose, the Z-height orientation has a better Z-height. It's about 60 millimeters shorter. On the other hand, the support surface is almost 173 millimeters squares larger for the maximum XY section orientation. Using such information, you can choose the most suitable orientation for your parts. Finally, you can use the Orientation Optimizer. This tool helps you optimize your orientation based on criteria that you can define. Go to the Build Preparation or Position ribbon and click on Orientation Optimizer. Start by updating measurements from the Analyze tab. Next on, move to the Optimize tab and tick the criteria you would like to optimize for. You can either optimize for a single criterion or combine a few criteria. In the latter case, the algorithm will find a balance between the criteria. Using the slider, you can assign a relative priority level to your criteria. In this case, reducing the Z-height will have more priority over minimizing the maximum XY section. You can finalize the optimization by clicking on Optimize. An important highlight of the Orientation Optimizer is the ability to minimize support on a marked region. All you need to do is mark the region and analyze. Please note that 100% of this region needs support. And from the Optimize tab, enable optimization for support unmarked. Let's optimize. Now, the same region needs no support. Please remember that part geometry is a limiting factor in orientation optimization. For example, it may not be possible to completely eliminate the support on a part due to its shape. For any orientation tool that you use, you can either use the result as is, or you can always use the rotation tool to fine-tune the orientation. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.